All right, so we're here at the Mid-Atlantic Overland Festival, and we're very excited for this opportunity to test out two very different but very capable off-road bikes. So I'm gonna talk about this one first. This is the Haibike XDURO NDURO 6.0. It's $5,600. This is an e-mountain bike, which is of course very much a growing trend. And this particular one features a 5.7 pound battery. It's a 500 watt Bosch performance line motor. This battery charges in about 4.5 hours and then you're good to go. This bike is definitely not light, but with the battery and the motor behind you, you can pedal assist up to 20 miles per hour. It also features 180 millimeter travel shocks on the front and the back. And so you really got a lot of play when you're tackling mountain bike terrain, whether you're looking at like, you know, just sort of rolling berms or rocky trails or steep, steep drops. It's gonna be able to handle all of those pretty smoothly. I generally find that mountain bike performance these days has reached a point where it outperforms most of the people that are riding the bikes, myself included. And I'm very much looking forward to playing around with this one and seeing what it can do.
All right, so here we have a very different bike, but it's built for the exact same sort of terrain. This is Allied's Able. It's a gravel bike. Starts at $4,000 for the frame only. We have the full build here. This one is $9,500. This is a gravel bike, so it's a mashup between a road bike and a mountain bike, essentially. On the spectrum between those two types of bikes, this one leans a little bit more towards a mountain bike. One of the reasons why I say that this bike leans a little bit more towards a mountain bike is because of these big tires that Allied has on here. They raise the chainstay here. And essentially what that does is it gives the Able the clearance for those big tires, but it keeps it closer to the frame. That keeps the bike nice and nimble and fast. The Able is also super light. This model with all the parts on it, 17.85 pounds. The frame on its own is 3.75 pounds. Allied is kind of an interesting company. It's based in Little Rock, Arkansas. They're only a couple years young. Most carbon fiber bikes these days are made in China. There's like 5 factories. Most of them are coming out of those factories. Allied's whole mission was to make carbon fiber bikes in the United States. So they're doing it in Little Rock. This bike came out earlier this summer and it debuted right up against a big race called the Dirty Kanza. 200 mile race on just like gnarly dirt roads in pretty much the middle of nowhere, Kansas. The men's and women's category winners were both riding this bike, which is kind of amazing. It was totally brand new and it won like the craziest gravel race around. That alone gives this bike a really good pedigree. We're excited to get it out on some of the dirt roads and trails here in Pennsylvania.
So I'm just gonna take you through some of the apparel that I'm wearing for this test. This is the Abus Montrailer helmet. It's specifically designed for mountain biking. It does have this handy little adjustable visor situation. It comes in a variety of styles and SKUs and the prices really vary. I'm also wearing a couple pieces from Mission Workshop. This shirt is the District MC Merino Wool Henley. It's $139, and these are the Traverse XC shorts. They're $130. I also have this Mission Workshop Axis Modular Hip Pack. These are becoming more and more popular in the mountain bike world. And this thing's pretty sweet. It's got plenty of storage for all your gear and kind of keeps it off your back and just kind of out of the way, but you can grab snacks or a different pair of lenses or you know, anything else, maybe your tools in here whenever you need them. And then it just kind of tucks away behind you when you're riding. One thing that's pretty cool about this tip pack is that it does have this quick release buckle where basically you just pull this little tab and you can release it, which honestly is maybe not your number one concern on the mountain, but it is kind of a cool little feature. And there is definitely like a tactile satisfaction to operating it. Just snaps back into place like so and you're good to go. Additionally, I'm wearing some Pearl Azumi stuff, including the Men's Attack glove. This is $30. I'm also wearing the Men's X-Alp Flow flat pedal shoes. Those are $100. And then this button-up shirt, which is pretty well styled to handle both on-bike activities and off-bike stuff. This is $85, and those are all on Polizumi's website.
All right, so I'm gonna be riding, you know, a mix of road and trail, so I've sort of dressed appropriately for that. Got kit from Velocio. This is the Radiator Trail Tee, $79. And then underneath I've got their Concept Bib Short, sort of like a high-end sort of race design. It's $289 for those. So for shoes, I've got Specialized S-Works Recon gravel shoes. These are $425. Sort of a hybrid between a road shoe and a mountain bike shoe. So I also have a little handlebar bag on my bike just to carry, you know, snacks and my phone and other little things, because I don't really know how long I'm going to be out there for. The bag is Ornott's bar bag. It's $68. I also have Wahoo's Element Roam computer on here. This thing is also new this year. It's packed with a bunch of sweet navigational features, maps and things like that. So don't really have to plan where I'm going. I can just sort of use this and make it up as I go.
So Tanner and I are back from the Overland Festival now. We're back in the office, fully recovered. We've had a chance to compose our thoughts about these two very different bikes that we got to thoroughly test out on that Pennsylvania terrain. And here are our thoughts. So what's really interesting about bikes like the Haibike is the way that they democratize mountain biking, allowing the less elite among us to access terrain we may have never dreamed of just a few years ago. You can climb just about anything with this bike, which is really what's fun about it. You do have to work a little bit, but definitely a lot less than you have to on a traditional mountain bike. In testing, we found that the shocks were more than adequate. They're Fox shocks, and they're over 7 inches of travel on the front and back. And you combine that with the tires, which are pretty beefy. They're 27.5 inch by 2.6 inch.
Which is a full inch wider than the tires that were on the Allied bike that I rode.
Those really made for a lot of stability on just about all the terrain that we hit. You could pretty much cruise over like gnarly rocks and logs, and you know, there's a lot more sweat than blood, I would say, which sometimes happens during traditional mountain biking, in my own experience. I would say, and this is where like you can draw a huge distinction between the Haibike and the Allied bike, is the weight. What does the gravel bike weigh?
It's the one we had was just less than 18 pounds.
Okay, and this Haibike, I don't know the exact number on it, but it's gotta be like,
like 50.
A lot, like twice as much, yeah. At least.
Yeah.
So this really stood out to me when I was like going over a little ridge and I just tried to like bunny hop at the top of it, and that's just not happening. So you can't really do some of the kind of fun things that you can do on much lighter bikes. And of course, if your battery ever died in the woods, you'd be pretty screwed. But that being said, you know, it's just a super fun bike. You know, when you're a kid, you don't feel tired, and that's kind of how this bike is. Whereas like the gravel bike, you do have to do more work.
Yeah, it's funny though, because like I could describe the Able in so many of the same terms that you just described that electric mountain bike. You know, the fact that it's so light and yet so capable on terrain that we were on, you know, like the fields and the dirt roads and like these off-road tracks, that combination just helps you go fast. And you really don't, like, you don't have to work as hard going up hills as you would on, say, like a traditional mountain bike, mm-hmm. on this gravel bike. So it kind of shares that concept with the e-mountain bike. Another thing I really liked about the Able is it's got a 1x12 drivetrain.
Haibike actually is the same.
A 1x12?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. So maybe you share this thought too, but you know, when we're out riding up and down hills and on trails and stuff, like I thought it was super nice not to have to think about, you know, shifting the front set and the back set of
gears. Definitely. Literally just up and down.
Yeah, just up and down. You can just kind of focus on more about the, you can focus more on the terrain than, you know, what the bike is doing and what you have to do to the bike to get up that terrain.
Totally, yeah.
So that was kind of one of my favorite things about this bike. you know, whether it's due to that raised chainstay and sort of the shorter rear end or not, the Able handled so well out on the trails and in the fields. Steve, you brought up your big fat tires, and we were sort of talking about the Allied's bike, you know, its tires being big. Compared to yours, it's not. But right. Even saying that, like the 43 millimeter tires that I had on this bike were like fully capable of handling everything we were riding on. Like at one point we were just riding through a field with tall grass and no trail or road or anything, and the bike was totally fine.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
There were some moments where like the terrain got like a little squishy where I noticed that I had to work a little bit mm-hmm. harder, but that was kind of it. And other than that, the bike, you know, you can ride this bike literally anywhere. And I've been riding it here in New York too, since we've been back. And it's, you know, it's still fast on the asphalt. And it's, I would say it's just as fun riding it in the city as it is out up and down hills in Pennsylvania.
But it handles potholes a little better than your traditional road bike too, right?
Yeah, that's for sure. For me, this thing is just super versatile. You can ride it anywhere and you kind of like want to ride it everywhere.
Just probably don't want to lock it up on the street in the city.
Do not anywhere. Lock it up.
Out of your sight line, yeah. Anyone who knows is gonna try to get that thing,
yeah,
for
this
sure.
This thing lives in your bedroom.
Yeah.